James Logman joins us from London to explain what Cambridge Analytica alleged to have done with Facebook. Good morning, James.
Good morning. Yes, it's a very, very intriguing story, and I think one which a lot of people at home might, you know, be interested in, but they might not particularly completely understand how this data got hold of it. So why don't I start with that? Cambridge Analytica is alleged to have used a third party, an academic, to get Facebook to give him loads and loads of data, possibly 50 million American users. And what they did was develop an app which, you know, people listening will have seen many times on Facebook, one of those personality apps. You click on it and you answer questions about yourself. But by doing that, they would then give Cambridge Analytica the permission to take their data, not just their data, but that of all of their friends. And that's how they got to that 50 million marker. The problem was that whilst lots of companies do this, they have to pay for that data ordinarily. And Cambridge Analytica didn't do that. They told Facebook that it was academic, and so they just got hold of it like that. The second issue was that they then used all of this information, all the stuff on, you know, what you're liking online, what you're browsing, what groups you're part of, but particularly the kind of political ideas you might have. They used all of that information to create personality profiles on people and then start to target them, what they call micro-targeting, individual on an individual basis, with messages which would induce paranoia and fear about the future, and possibly then change their minds when it came to a political, when it came to an election. So that is what the allegation against Cambridge Analytica is. And now there's a whole new thing happening in today in the UK after Channel 4 News, the broadcaster, filmed an undercover meeting between the CEO of Cambridge Analytica and some actors posing as possible investors in an election campaign. And he not only tried to sell them this idea that they could do this with data, but also some of the older techniques that people at home will have known about, you know, with seen the political thrillers, like, you know, entrapment and corruption, finding, you know, prostitutes to send them round to the opposition and film it, so in order to entrap them, posing as property tycoons in order to get, you know, to entrap the opposition in kind of phony but very, very dangerous kind of big property deals. So there is a lot of concern now about this particular company, and it matters to Americans because this company, after the whistleblower was working there in 2014, 2 years later, it became part of the Trump campaign, also worked for the Ted Cruz campaign. So there are a lot of questions now that need to be answered what they were doing.
Sure. What's interesting, though, is did they do the same thing for Ted Cruz? And if they did, they couldn't manipulate voters to vote for Ted Cruz, but the argument is they could for Donald Trump.
Right. Well, I mean, that's exactly right. I mean, just how effective is this is the big question. What Donald Trump's campaign has very clearly said is that they didn't use any of that data. All their data came from the RNC. I think the big issue is what these companies were prepared to do and just what level of involvement Steve Bannon may have had in those early days of when they were kind of developing these sorts of ideas. Yeah. They were testing, according to the whistleblower, phrases like drain the swamp and build the wall, things like this. These, again, I have to make clear, are allegations by the whistleblower, but they do suggest a very long association between Steve Bannon and this particular company, and that would suggest that they played quite a major role in the Trump campaign. But
right. So
none of this is provable yet.
Sure. Now, the other allegation is that Cambridge Analytica, or this third party, took this information from Facebook, in which Facebook usually sells. Is Facebook upset that it was taken without being paid for? It doesn't sound like it was stolen. They weren't hacked. So is Facebook upset that this data wasn't paid for?
They're upset that it wasn't paid for, but the thing is that what people find a bit fishy is that Facebook actually, any time data is taken from their website, that markers come up, flashpoints come up. They knew about it 2 years ago. Chris Wiley says they knew about this when it was happening. They then informed Cambridge Analytica, according to him, that they needed to stop it or that they had to promise that they weren't using it for any other reason than just academic. All they had to do was sign a form and send it back to Facebook, and Facebook apparently was happy with that. It was only now that Facebook realizes how big a story this is. They tried to again, Chris's words, spike it by bringing this announcement forward that they were going to ban Cambridge Analytica. So what Facebook is primarily upset about is this reputational damage, because it might be, and this is the allegation, that Facebook knows full well that all kinds of people do this on its website. It earns them money, it earns them outreach, it gets hold of, it makes sure that data, Facebook is going to continue to be used by all these political operators, and it kind of doesn't mind as long as no one tells them.
Right.
Whereas they actually, there could be some real questions that not just Cambridge Analytica, but Facebook now has to answer.
James Logman, great stuff. ABC News 4 correspondent live in London. James, thanks for the update.